Once again, welcome to Press Your Luck, the show where you can win a bundle or you can, of course, lose your shirt. And now let's meet the players who are going to be pressing their luck today, starting with our returning champion, Jim. All of it. $7,293. Jim, I understand you ransacked for antiques, ransacked houses for antiques.
Oh,
you ransacked
yeah.
us for about $7,293. How do you feel?
Oh, great. Happy as could be. You can
ready to win more?
I'm ready to give it a try.
You look like you are. All right, Jim, let's meet your competitors, starting with our second contestant, Joan Forer. Hiya, Joan.
Hi, I'm Joan Forer. I live in Los Angeles. I do executive research work, and I'm glad to be here.
No, but I was told you're a movie star.
Well, that's a former, much former.
Tell us about that. That's that.
Well, every Easter, if you watch television, you see me eaten by the lions. I was 5 years old, and I was in the Sky of a Cross, and I was eaten every year, and I get to see myself at five. It's fun.
Great. You get residual checks?
I do a little bit.
All right. Great, John. Welcome. And let's meet our third player, Dan DeBakis.
DeBakis.
I knew I'd get it.
Okay,
Dan,
got it. How are you? Dan DeBakis. Pretty good. I'm married, 5-year anniversary coming up real soon, and have three wonderful little children.
Welcome to our show. Are you all ready to win some money?
Sure am.
I tell you what, I've got four questions. Your correct answers will earn you spins at our big board. The more spins you have, the more money you can win. Because as you know, our board is loaded with thousands of dollars in cash, terrific prizes. Every time you stop the board like this, stop! You'll make money, as I just did. However, there is something else that can happen, and that's called the whammy. If he comes out, he will deprive you of all your funds. And that's a thing you want to avoid like the plague. With that in mind, are you all ready to press your luck?
Ready.
Ready.
Here we go with the first question. According to the latest survey, which household chore do at least 80% of men help with? Dan.
Dishes.
All right. Dan says it's the dishes. If he's right, he's going to get three spins. I'll take Dan's answer and two others. Give them to Jim and Joan. If they're right, they'll earn a spin apiece. Is the correct answer dishes, garbage, or cooking, Jim?
I'm going to say garbage, Steve.
Jim is going to say garbage, and we're going to go to Joan and see what she says.
I'll deal with some garbage.
You're going to say garbage. Well, 80% of the men pitch in and help with the garbage. Right. Jim gets a spin. Joan gets a spin. Out of the lion's den, and Dan stays with nothing so far, but we got more questions, Dan. Here comes the second one. According to a study done by the Carnegie Foundation, on what subject in the curriculum should high schools be placing the most emphasis? Jim.
I'd say math, Peter.
Math, all right. Is the correct answer math, English, or science? Joan?
I would say science.
Joan would say science. Let's see what Dan has to
say. I'll go with the English.
You will say English. Carnegie Foundation findings tell us the most emphasis should be placed on English.
All right.
Dan's right. Go. Jim says the one. Joan goes to one. Stays at one. And Dan goes to one. Everybody's got one. Here we go with the third question. More boats are sold in this state than in any other. What state is it, Jim?
Florida.
Florida is the correct answer. Florida, New York, or California, Joan?
California.
Joan says it's California. Let's go to Dan.
I'll go with Florida.
Florida. Well, the fact of the matter is most boats are sold in the state of Florida. That means that Big Jim goes to Big Four because he buzzed in. Valuable spin. Joan stays at one. Dan goes to two. Here is our fourth and final question. Members' spins turn into money. Here it comes. What Hollywood actor started the scandal called Hollywood Gate when he blew the whistle on a studio head who forged the actor's check? Joan?
Cliff Robertson.
All right, is the correct answer Cliff Robertson, Warren Beatty, or Jack Nicholson? Jim?
I'll say Cliff Robertson, too.
Jim will say Cliff Robertson. Let's go over to Dan.
I'll go with the crowd. Cliff Robertson.
Cliff Robertson. Well, Hollywood Gate was started by Cliff Robertson. Everybody picks up spin. That means that Jim goes to five. Joan picks up big three and goes to four. Dan goes to three. All you have a chance to push this game into big dress without dollars. We come back right after this. Don't go away. Time to take those spins and turn them into dollars. We've got prizes up there on that board. We've got $13,000 in cash. And, of course, a few whammies up there just to keep you honest. Now, each spin can bring you up to $1,500, and that's important because the player who ends this round on top gets to play last in the final round. And, as you know, that's a big advantage because that puts you in control. But remember, you can pass your remaining spins anytime you're afraid of the whammy. And everything at the stake each time you spin, four whammies put you out of the game. All right, are you ready? We're going to go with the player with the fewest spins, and that is, of course, Dan. No dollars, three big spins, Dan. You ready?
Ready.
Let's get the $1,500 right off the bat.
Okay. Stop.
Stop at $200 and a spin. So you're ahead of the game. Still have your three spins. Here we go, says Dan.
Stop.
Stop at $300 again. Well, actually, not again. Actually, it's up to $500. You had $200 the first time. Two spins left. Gotta go, says Dan.
Stop
at... Oh, well. The best thing is to get him over with now, you know, let him...
Save it for the second round.
All right, one spin left, you can make some money, Danny, are you ready?
Ready.
Here we go. Let's get the big dollars. Stop at $750, Dan. Okay, you're in the money column. We'll now go to Joan, our movie star with no dollars and four spins. You ready, Joan?
Ready.
You can get rediscovered here. Stop at $470, Joan. Well done, three spins left, want to keep going?
Yes.
Joan says, let's go.
Stop.
Oh, well. Not who you want to touch again, Joan, but you've got two spins left. You've got them out of your system. No dollars. You ready?
I'm ready. Let's
make some money.
Stop.
Stop it. Big buck. Oh, $100, Joan. That'll get off. That puts you in first place by $500. One spin left. What are you going to do?
I'm going to go.
You're going to go. Okay. $1,250 at stake.
Stop.
Stop at a portable television zone. Worth $320. Brings your total to $1,570. And you're in first place for now. We're going to go see what Jim's going to do with $0, but he's got five big spins. Jim, you ready?
You bet.
All right. Here goes the champ.
Stop.
Stop at $1,250. Second place. Four spins. You ready?
You bet. So let's go.
Here we go. Everyone's got one whammy. That's enough. Three spins left. Jim, you want to make some money?
You betcha. Let's
go. Okay, we're going to make some.
Stop.
Oh. Oh, well, I tell you. I just let it fall down at me. Bye, Jim. You've gotten your share in someone else's. That's enough. Two spins left. You want to make some money? All right, you got... You can pass if you want.
Do it again.
You're going to do it again. All right, keep going. One more. Stop at $200. All right, you got into the money column, Jim. 200, third place, one spin left, two whammies. You have to deal with some strategy here because you don't want to go in with three whammies in round two. You can pass or you can go take that
pass.
You can pass, let spin get past to Jones and choose the player with the highest amount of money. Jones, 1570, first place at stake. You hit a whammy and that means Dan has first place.
Stop.
Money.
$600,
Jones. 2170, excellent. That means Jim's got $200, Dan, $750, and Joan, you're leading with 2170, which is no advantage. We'll be right back with more questions, spins, prizes, surprises, right after this. We'll be right back. spins in this round. Spins are even more important than they were in the first round, in that a spin in this round can be worth as much as $5,000. I've got four questions, which means you can earn some more spins. The player who ends this round on top gets to take that money home and come back again. And that's real nice. Now, with that in mind, are you all ready to play?
Yeah.
Here's your first question. The food of what country is regarded as the favorite foreign food of Americans? Joan?
Chinese.
All right. If you're right, Joan, you will pick up three spins. I'll take your answer and two others. Give it to Jim and Dan. If they're right, they will earn a spin apiece. Is the correct answer Chinese, Mexican, or Italian, Jim?
I'm going to say Italian.
Jim is going to say Italian, and we'll swing over to Dan to see what he thinks.
I'll go with Mexican.
You'll pick Mexican. Well, our favorite foreign food is Italian. That means Jim picked up a spin. Joan and Dan, yet to be heard from. All right, we've got more questions. Here's the second one. According to a recent poll, when asked what is their primary source of morning news, what did more people answer? Dan?
The paper.
Newspaper.
Newspaper.
All right. Is the correct answer newspaper, television, or radio, Jim?
I'm going to say radio, Peter.
Jim is going to say radio. We'll go to Joan to see what she says.
I think I have to agree with you, Jim.
What are you going to say, Jim?
Radio.
Radio? Well, most people get their morning news from the radio. That means that Jim picks up a spin, and Joan picks up a spin. Could be worth as much as $5,000, Joan. Dan is yet to be heard from, but we've got the third question. Here it is. What food comes in varieties called Catawba, Muscadine, Niagara, and Concord? Joan.
Grape.
All right. Is the correct answer grape, apples, or cherries? Jim?
Grape.
Jim says it's grape. Let's see what Dan says.
Definitely grape.
Grape. Well, those are all varieties of grape, indeed. That means that Jim goes to three. Joan buzzed in. She picks up three and hits a big four, and Dan hits the circle with one. And here's our fourth and final question. According to the advertisement, what coffee-growing country is the home of Juan Valdez? Jim?
Brazil.
Brazil. That's the correct answer. Brazil, Colombia, or Argentina? Joan?
Colombia.
Joan says it's Colombia. Let's go to Dan.
I'll go Colombia.
Colombia. Well, the renowned Juan Valdez resides in Colombia. That means Jim stays at three. Joan goes to five. And Dan goes to two. Big spin to the real big board to find out who the winner is going to be on Such a Lot. Don't go away. Players, it's time for that magical moment when we translate spins into big dollars. And we've got 50,000 of those big dollars up there just waiting for you to get your hands on them. We also have some whammies, so be very careful, because if he jumps out, he takes away your money. Now, the player who came in first in round one is Joan with $2,170. Joan, you're in a great position. You can sit back and relax while Jim and Dan fight it out. You'll be last. That's important. All right, the player with the least amount of money is our champ, Jim, with two whammies, $200, and three spins. Jim, you ready to make some big bucks?
You bet.
All right, go up to that $5,000 and get it. Oh, Jim. Jim, you're not in a great place. Let's take a look at it. You've got no dollars. You do have two spins, but your situation is such that you have three whammies. One more whammy puts you out of the game. So you want to deal with strategy and be very careful about what you do. You've got two spins left. Very difficult to win in third place, which is where you are, but be careful. Let's go. Okay, Jim says, let's go for it. Advance two spaces to $1,000, Jim. Puts you in second place, $250 more than Dan. About $1,000 less than Joan, one spin left. What do you want to do, Jim? Three whammies. Let's go. We're going to go. Oh, gutsy move, Jim. Take off.
Stop.
Oh, Jim. Oh, sorry, Jim. Took the gamble. It didn't work. Four whammies. Okay. Sit back and relax. We're now going to go to Dan with $750. Two spins, one whammy. Are you ready, Dan?
I'm ready.
Got to beat Joan 2170. Stop! Oh, spin! That brings you up real quick to 5750. Two spins because you picked up one. You're in first place by about $3,600. What do you want to do?
I'll press my luck.
Dan's going to go for it. 5750 is stake. Big money is stake. Oh, Surf is up. Dan, 5750 gone. Two whammies, no dollars. All right, here's the situation. You have one spin left, no dollars. Jones with 21.70.
Oh, I got a play.
You got a play.
No.
Oh, good.
Oh, big putt.
No dollars, no more spins, but Jones got five spins. He has to play them, or she can pass them. She can pass them back to you, but we've got to deal with those spins. So, Joan, you got five. 21.70.
I'll go.
Gonna go? All right, here she goes.
Stop
at $2,000, Jones. Congratulations, that brings you up to 4170. A hunk of money, four spins left. Now you can keep going, or you can pass those spins today.
I'm gonna go.
Joan's gonna go for it. 41.70 at stake, one whammy. Stop at $1,500. Oh. Building up a small fortune, Jones. 56.70. Three spins left. What do you want to do now?
I'm a gambler. I'm going to test my luck.
Jones going to press your luck. 56.70 at stake.
Okay, here
goes. $3,000 and a spin, Jones. Now you're at $8,670. You still have three spins because you picked up one on that. What are you going to do? Press your luck or pass those spins?
I'm going to press my luck. I think all the whammies are out.
Don't think all the whammies are gone. I hope she's right. So press your luck. 8670 at stake. Guys, recovered. All safe, Jones. Took away your 86.70. No dollars, but you still have two spins left. So you got some strategy to deal with. Okay. You got two whammies. Dan's got three. Neither of you have any dollars. Are you ready to press your luck, or are you going to pass to Dan?
One time,
says Joan. Okay.
Stop.
Oh. All right. Now you've got a real dilemma, Joan. You have three whammies, no dollars, one spin. If you pick up a whammy, you're out of the game. If you pick up anything other than a whammy to get you money, you're going to win. You could pass it to Dan. If he whammies, he's out of the game and you win. Because if he whammies and gets out of the game, you come back with no dollars since they both whammied out. The other alternative is that if Dan makes the money, he wins. He's the champion. So you've got a lot to deal with here. What do you want to do?
I'll play.
You want to play? All right, Joan's going to go herself, see if she can make some money. And see the championship to take advantage. She takes $1,000. Joan, you are the champion for the day. What a lucky move. Congratulations. And we'll be right back to find out exactly what you won. Right after this, we know what you won. $6,000, Joan. Congratulations.
Barbara, you up?
We're back with today's big press your luck winner, Joan. Joan, you did it with $1,000. Congratulations.
Awesome.
All right. You know, it's got to be the strangest game I think I've ever seen, where at the end we had Jim had whammied out. You had three whammies. Dan had three whammies. So it was possible that if you had picked up a whammy, Dan would have won with no dollars. Or if you had passed it to Dan and he had picked up a whammy, you would have won it with no dollars. Very, and it's, look at it, 10 whammies. Yeah, I've never seen that.
I didn't know which way to go.
Well, you went the right way, Joan, because you got $1,000 and you won the game. That's really what matters. And Jim, four whammies, you got whammies. Whammy and whammy.
Yeah.
Yeah, real bad, but you're going to walk away with $7,200.
All right.
$3. Well done. What are you going to do with the money, Jim?
Play with it.
Just toss it up and down for a while, yeah. That's nice. Maybe you can earn some interest that way. You can multiply a bit. Well, that's a nice hunk of change. Nice having you with us. You're a great champ. Dan, you were caught in all this with the whammies and everything. You played well.
Well, I don't know. They didn't seem to treat me too well. But that's life. Little whammies. I'll get them someday.
You'll get them someday. That's a good attitude to have, Dan. Well, you were a valiant contestant. You played it well. We've got some prizes for you. You were definitely not going away empty-handed.
Good.
See? And everybody had a good time.
Yeah.
And Joan. Joan, we'll see you next time.
That's it.
Until then, remember, the whammy is no mirage. He's certain to put you in the garbage. This is Peter DeMarkin saying so long for Press Your Luck. Bye-bye. Here's what we have for our departing contestants. Quartel presents this hand-blown crystal lamp from the South Malay Collection, designed to add beauty and warmth to your home, exclusively by Quartel Lighting. Plus, Icy Hot relieves arthritis pain for hours with even coolness, plus penetrating warmth. Use Icy Hot only as directed. And for international entertaining or everyday meals, West Bend's delightful coriander wok. It's ideal for stir-frying, simmering, and stewing. Plus, family. sandwich mate. It's better than American cheese. Why? More vitamins, minerals, great cheese taste, and sandwich mate cost less, too. Also, Sunset, the automotive alarm systems are built by Sun Electric Corporation. For more than 50 years, the most trusted name in automotive car care products. And new Nat Robbins lip liner. Invisible, silky soft lip care cream. Helps stop lipstick bleeding and feathering. Improves the look and feel of your lips. Ready for fast-paced excitement and fabulous showcases on The Price is Right with the priceless Bob Barker. Come on down to The Price is Right, coming up next.